Welcome to the next tutorial here on our YouTube channel and on the series We Make a Survival Game in Third Person. And I see some comments on YouTube, and I see we're starting this series, and some guys are working more, have creating shooting system, have problem with the ammo and so on. So my tip is wait. When we are on that, we bring it into. We will have later, when we see here in this corner, we have the weapon and the ammo text to see how many ammo we have and account for the magazine. For the bullet magazine, that is what we bring in the next tutorials. I understand that that you must wait for it. For me, I have a main job, I have a real life, I have a family, and I cannot bring the tutorials every day out. On my main job, I working sometimes 7 days on a week. I working in a hospital station, and that is at the moment a problem. I have not so much free time, and when I have 1 or 2 days free, so I have sometimes not the motivation to say, okay, we make the next tutorial. And sometimes I have all not the time, for do it. So when you have a family, you understand it. And that is why I cannot bring every day for it. So, and at the moment, when I take a look on the YouTube channel, we have at the moment 827 subscribers. That's really great. And when I take a look, we have 3185 hours of watch time. That's great. The mod's watch time come out from the Let's Plays, what I have starting last year in the summer. I've starting creating German Let's Plays here on my channel. And when I'm looking the analytics from the last video, so we have 111 looks on it, and we have a watch time from 2 hours. So you see the correlation, the elevation to it. So, and I hope we bring the channel to the YouTube partner program. That's my goal. So at the moment I make this all for free. I get no money from YouTube or money from some other. So that's no problem for me. So I make it free for you. I see we have 85 % from the views are not subscriber. It's okay. But yeah, that is what I will tell you is I have not time, and sometimes I have not the motivation for it to make really fast tutorials here on the channel at the moment. I will make pauses starting Playmaker tutorial. So at the moment I have not the time to do it. So, and you have seen I have starting streaming here on the channel. Sometimes I streaming devlog, the last devlog stream or dev stream what I have doing was at the night. I can't no sleep on the night. I have say, okay, I make a stream for Unity, and on this I have create a little top down shooter with a little AI. That was funny, I think. The next streams I continue this, and this was a silent stream, no voice from my side. I have play only music in the background. This was a working stream for me. So, and when I make a working stream, I must not tell to you, I must not say so many, and when I say many, that cost time. See, now we are now at the moment at the intro. But yeah, and on the other side, I will do some gaming, some Let's Plays gaming streams here on the channel. The last was Elite Dangerous, it was funny, 2 hours, really cool. That is what I will bring together. I will make it gaming streams here and devlog and Unity tutorials and all this, put it together. That is my goal, what I'm doing here. Later, in months or years, when we are much bigger, then we can switching to Twitch, but at the moment I see no solution to get to Twitch. Yeah. So, but now we will starting here at our tutorial. And what we will do, at the last tutorial we have bring the rival to it, yeah? So that was what we have creating, and we must creating here something more. So let's see, I'll make play to see what we have the problem. So the idea is, when we press the right button, our camera will zoom to the player model and make an offset to right, yeah, to that we will see the shoulder view. That's the idea. The problem is, when I go forward and I'm now in a shoulder view and I press left, you see the character, yeah, go to the input vector what we have creating. That's okay, but that is not what we need for it. So for this we must create a blend tree, yeah. So at first we make right click from new blend tree, okay, and we going on parameters. We need for the blend tree, we need two parameters. Why? So at the moment we have a one type, so we need 2D freeform directional, yeah. And you see on this blend tree we have two parameters here. At the moment we have input magnitude. The two parameters from the blend tree are flute parameters. So, and for this we will create two new parameters for flute. So the first is the horizontal, what we are creating, and the second is the vertical, yeah. So make a new flute, I put it here vertical in. So when you reminded, we was, as we started in a project settings, here's the input, and you see for left and right is horizontal and for forward backward is vertical. That is what we are will doing here. So at the first we say here vertical and here horizontal, okay. So and now we create a motion field, yeah. So and on this motion field we looking for the rival look CC additive, and that is on 0 0. So we have here for the x coordinate, and we have here for the y coordinate, and this is 0, and the time is, the animation speed is 1. That's okay. And here we have the option to make a mirror of it. You see he's switching, yeah, to mirror it, yeah, but we don't need it. So we need a new motion field, and you see here we get here a little window, and on this we're looking for river walk forward, yeah, the river walk forward loop, yeah. So and for now we say here 1 in the vertical and here 0. So and let's see, at the moment we are here on 0. When I push it to 1, we're going forward, and when I press to 0, nothing do. So and the next is, we have now forward, we need backward, rival walk backward loop, yeah. So and you see he bring it on self, he said -1. That's right, that is -1. So let's see, we can go forward and now we're going backward, yeah. See it here and back. Okay, so what is the next, what we need? We need river strafe, and now river strafe left, yeah. So and for this is 0 left, go not forward, but he going on the left side. So we make minus one. Yeah. Yeah. That is the next. So and here we're looking for new, and now we're looking for riffle, strafe, right, right loop. Yeah, that is the next. And this is, and he going on right, he going not forward, but he going for right, and that is not minus, that is one. Okay, so we can make a test. It's now here. So at the moment we're going backward, let's go forward, you see, okay. So but make it zero, and now we make it, I make this, see here, that is the compass for forward. And now we see we have one and we're going right. And when I press minus one, we're going back to left. Problem is when I press here this, one and minus one, he going in this solution and we have no animation here. And you see here, what is the problem? You see here, that looks not good with the foods. Okay, for this is the next what we are creating. So, and for this, we're looking for riffle 45, strafe right 45, is it, or we have left? At the first, let's take left. So let's see what do it. And you see he going forward and left. Yeah. So for this is for forward is one and for left is minus one. That is it. The next is what we need is for forward right. So that is river 45, let's take a look here, strafe right 45 loop, and that is forward for one and for right is one. Okay, so let's see, now we are here forward, so make here for the better seeing. So and now I make one and we're going in this side. Yeah, okay, good. But we need two more. We see here this field are empty, and now we're going new motion field, rival 135, and for strafe left, and that is for backward minus one and for left minus one. Yeah, so and then we have here field this field. Okay, so next motion field for the end is rival strafe the right, yeah, okay, riffle strafe right 135 loop. Okay, so this is minus one for backward and here one, and you see we have filled it up. Okay, so we can look in a test. At the moment we're going forward, so we're going backward and now to the other side. Yeah, so that is our blend tree. And going back here, and we're calling the blend tree to riffle aim. Okay, so and that is when our player going on. The idea is when he going forward and he pressed the right key from the mouse, he will aiming, and then we will going in this. So our problem is when he going back, so we need here our idle. Yeah, so we create here empty stat to make look it smoother when he going out from the blend tree and the idle and back to the idle when you are not more aim. So this is aiming idle. So and for this we rival look CC additive. Yeah, that is what we are needing here in this. And now we make here a transition and make here a transition. So at the first we say food IK it's on, food IK it's on, going in this transition. And now we're seeing here input magnitude is greater as 0.1, has no exit time, and here we set input magnitude is less as 0.1 and the exit time off. Yeah. So, and now for this we going back, we want going back to our idle and from the idle into it. So, and for this we need a bool. We have seen when we are press the right key from the mouse, we will going in aim. So we need the bool for aim, the parameter aim. So on this we saying here aim, it's true. Or we going here and set in aim is false. Yeah. So that is what we are needing for this. So, but we need some other stuff. Yeah. Bring it here. Mix this here. So, or make it so. We need here transition. And that is when the input magnitude is greater as 0.1. We're going in this blend tree. But we need another condition. We need aiming. When aiming is true, then he going to it. And now when we have set here, input magnitude is greater as 0.1. And we set here aim is not true, is false. Then he going back to this. Yeah, that's the idea. Later we must bring here, we must create later a crouching aiming blend tree again. That's come later. So, and the next what we are need is a layer, a new layer, and this is riffle. This is riffle for the upper body. So, and what will we doing here on this new layer? On this new layer, we will looking when he's shooting. And we will bring here to the upper body when he reload. Yeah. So that's the idea what we will bring to it. So, and at the first we must create empty. The problem is when we will here creating an IK pass, yes, and when we make it additive. So we will blend it over. We will blend the upper body over to it. And for doing this, let's create. Let me see how it is. Avatar mask. Yeah, and we call it upper body. Upper body player. Okay. So let's see what have we here. We have here a little human, and we have here IK points. And we have here some areas. So we have say we will here blend up the upper body. So we go in here, make IK off, the ground, IK off, and the feet off. So that is only what we need. Then we go in here and we putting our, oh wait, we can make it other. We can look in here, upper body player. That is what we have creating. And we bring it to it. Okay, that is this at the moment. But we need a little bit more. We need here the next stat. And for this is Riffle look. And this is here you see CC additive. Yeah. And this is idle upper body. Idle upper body. This will play every time when we are walking. Yeah, when we are walking and something. We will have this. At the next, what we need is a next state is for shooting. Yeah, when we are shooting, we need something for this. And we looking for riffle loop. So let me see riffle shoot loop additive. Yeah, this is, that is what we are as next one. What do it? Let us see here. Wrong key. So, und jetzt die hier, that is cool shooting. Yeah, he shooting the rifle every time. Okay, that is what we have here in it. And then we need another. And we're looking for it. For the reload. Rifle reload 2. Yeah. And we call it rifle reload. Okay. And yeah. So now we must create the transition to it. As first, from rifle reload. So when we are finished the reload, you see here, that is why we have upper body. You see here, make it. And we have the exit time. So let me see the settings for the exit time. I think that's okay. We can do it on it. Okay. The next is what we are needing. Make a transition to the idle upper body and a transition back to this idle upper body. So, and what is what we are will doing here? It's really simple. We make no exit time. Make the settings back, and let's see here, the condition is greater as 0.1, yes. And here is less 0.1, yes. That's right. And the next is when we are shooting. So, and for this we need a next bool, must create here for shoot. Yeah. So, and we're seeing here, shoot is true, no exit time. And the same is here when shoot, make a transition, shoot will be false. The next, no exit time. Yeah. And we need from here to shoot, when we are in idle and shoot, then we must bring here shoot is true. Okay. So, and now we need here when the input magnitude is less as 0.1 as first. And we need a next condition to it when shoot is false. Then he going back here, yeah. No, but I think we don't need it. So we will see later. Okay, that is our blend tree at the moment. We have no crouching in it, but that is what we are having now. And yeah, what is the next? What we are will doing at the next is or we make play. I think you see the problem better. So, and now we take our revel here, yeah. Okay, so and let's go into the animator. We must here at the moment set it up to 1, yeah. So, going here in our player model, yeah. So, and you see, that's it at the moment, but looks not so good, and we have the problem here with the gun. So for this we will using a little script. Let me see, I have here, that is a really little script for the IK handling. So what will do the script? This script will help us to bring the right hand and the left hand to the right position. So the idea is hold the left hand on his gun, bring it on the right position for the gun. So that is really simple here. We have a public class, is IK handling, that is the name of it here from the script. We looking for a public variable here for animator, this is anim here. We looking here for a flute, left hand right. And here is the same transform. We have here transform left and right. And transform vector for the weapon. That's that. So, and what do it? At the first, you get this component from the animator. and he make an update on an animator IK, and he say set IK position weight, so weight for the left hand goal, and for the position, for the rotation of it, and for the rotation. Yeah, that is what that's done. The same does on the right hand. Yeah. So we have here left hand weight, target position, and so on. Really simple. I upload this. You can download it as a link. I put it in the description. That is really, really a simple script for it, but this helped us. And now we're going to play a model, and we put this IK handling script to it. At first, we're setting up here our animator. The second is what we are will doing is we're going to import stuff. Not import stuff. We're going on the root, looking for our weapon holder. Not here. Here's our weapon holder. And we have here the right hand IK, what we have creating, and we have here the left hand IK. Yeah. So at the first is what we are setting up is the right hand target. We have here at the moment weapon. We will later bring this weapon to it with Playmaker. So, and we have here the left hand IK target here to this. So, and let's see what does it. So, and you see here I make it here. I think here we see it better. You see my left hand. Yeah, my left hand is broken. Yeah. That come for the left hand IK. Yeah. So, when we're looking here is my left hand IK. And when I'm moving it, you see that moves my left hand. Yeah. Yeah. Yay. Okay. So. But now we will we will fix it. Yeah, we will create a IK goal system a little. How we are using this the script. Bring it to the right position and hold the left hand on the right position. That is what we are doing on that. And let's see what need we. At the first we need the FSM. That is really simple, yeah. And we call it set IK hands. Yeah. So that will setting up the IK hands. So we open here it. Yeah. And for now we will at the first set the position of our right hand IK. So what will we do here? So let's go and set position here. Okay, and a specific object, the right hand. This is here in our player inside, so we must not create a variable for this. So okay, that is the first, and we will set it up to 0. Why we were setting up to 0? When we have later the pistol in it, or later a bow in it, the right hand IK will changing. Here's this. So, and when we equip this weapon, we have here a other value. So this is why we are at the first start, when this rifle is activated, he will bring the IK hands, starting this FSM, and then he's setting the right hand IK to 0. Yeah, and to self here in a space, a self, not in a world, not every frame or late update. That is the first what we are needing. And a second, we will set up the rotation. Set rotation. So and what will we are setting up? That is the same like here, the right hand IK handler. Yeah. For this, we will setting up this. We open this and make here 10 minus 90. That is, you must see for yours setting when you use other gun. But that is at the moment what we are here have for other stuff. And now we create a variable, and that is an object. And we call it IK handler. IK handler. That is our object, and we going on it, and here we have the IK handling. Yeah, that is that. And we looking for get component at the first. And we set here IK handling, and our IK handling is not here on this. Our IK handling is on our player model, and our player model, we have created a variable for us as animator model, so every frame. So, and as next, we will set property. We're looking for this function, set property here. We move this to the bottom, and we're looking here for IK handler. Now I see all what I have here in IK handler. At the first is enabled. We enabled it. Yeah, that is the first. And we copy this. We passed the action here. And the next is what we are looking for is the left hand target. Yeah, and we make it as transform. And this is here. So the left hand target will, when we have the upper weapon, will changing. Yeah. We have, that is why we have the left hand IK handler under the weapon. Okay, that is this. And we copy this. Passed. And now we're looking for the weapon transform. And the weapon transform is here our test rifle. Yeah. So that is the first, and we're calling events. We need start fast. Give us this global transition start fast. And now is the problem. When we have the IK handling, we're setting here all this up. The problem is the IK will every time hanging on the weapon. And that gives us the problem when we will reload. Let us see here for reloading animation. So we see here that is the reload. And now we see here he put his left hand back from the gun, takes his ammo, put it in, and yeah, that is what the left hand do it. And at the moment here in this IK hand script, we have setting up the left hand every time on a position what we are will setting up here. And when we are reloading, we need an off event. We make it here off. So we're going add global transition for off at the moment. Yeah. And that is really easy. What we are needing, we will disabled. Copy this. We will disable the IK handler. And this time when we are in the off state, yeah, so we make here enabled off, so let's save us, and we're going back to the player model, and we will disable this, so and let's see, so we are here, let's make it a little bigger, so I put my weapon to it. Okay, you see now we have here some problems, yeah? Yeah, we have many problems at the moment. So, at first is here our, we're looking on our right hand IK, yeah? And that have this settings, and this settings is nothing but we are have setting up. So let me see here, right hand IK is that. Set the rotation, and I think we have doing something wrong. We have not, yes, that is a problem. That is not the world, that is the self. So let me see. So now we are standing here, it's all okay. So putting up the weapon. So and now we see this. And we have here the values, what we are have putting in, but it looks not so good. So we can, so and this is a problem when we have here not global. So when we now have global, you see I can switch it smoothly, and I see here the values what I need. Yeah, so let's see again. So, now we're standing, the IK handler is not on, that's right. And now that is on. And but looks not so good for the moment, yeah. And that is why we are looking here. We have global, we have pivot, and now we can rotate this how we like it. Yeah. So let me see. Yeah, I think that looks good. A little bit more so. Okay. So now that is the value what I have here. For this I use from Windows the snipping tool. Yeah, this is a snipping tool. Have you in Windows? When you have Windows, I make this. And I select this here. I can set it off to it. And now I going here back to the test rival, the IK ghouls, and see what we are having. At first this was for set the rotation was -3.3. We make here this and here 180. So, and let's see a test. So, we bring our weapon in it, we activate it, the weapon or the handling looks good, I make it pause. And now I have here the test swivel on it and I will put it in the hand of our guy here. So, I make it a little bit down for it. Okay, I think that looks good. Okay, and yeah, I think that's okay for this gun at the moment. And now we copy this and pass the value. And I think we must the right hand key a little bit changing the rotation. So I open it, I put it into it. So. And now I going to the right hand IK, rotate it a little bit, so make it a little bit up, so let me see, a little bit too much, so okay, and now I will bring it a little bit to the body. So I think that's good. I think that's okay. But let give us the left hand back. Yeah, I think that looks okay for us. So let's see the right hand. I use my snipping tool again. And now set it off. And now I going back to set IK hands. And now we have here the rotation. Have change. -85. Then minus this and give us -3. I think that's it. Yeah, that's okay. And we can here setting up the position of is 0.0013. So okay, let's see us. So now we're standing here, weapon into, and that looks good. So and now we have the problem with our left hand IK, that is what we are for the end. We'll bring into, bring it up, let us rotate it a little bit. So Mix this. Okay, we make it a little bit more here. A little bit more up. A little bit down. And then we have here. I think that is a good position. A little bit more four. So I think that position looks good. For our left hand, we copy this value going out. Pass component value. And now let's see. On play. We're starting. We put this in our hand. And you see. When I run. And so on, looks good. So you can, that is really fast. You can make it more accurate, and that looks a little bit better asset, but it's okay. For our tutorial, it's okay. Yeah, I think that's okay. So that is how we are setting up our weapon. And in the next video, we're starting with Final Key and aiming. And after we have finished that, then we were starting with shooting. Yeah. Okay, my friends. It was a long video. I hope you have learned something. When you have questions, you can write it under the video. Or when you need help, come in our Discord channel. On that, I can better help you. So, that's it. I'm out. Have fun with it. See you on the next time. Bye-bye.